you know, sort of this growing movement of women coming forward to say they choose not to have children. And I noticed this percolating discussion that's getting louder and louder, where women, particularly also men, are coming forward to say, you know, I regret being a parent. You can read the article in McLean's on Newsstands or on the Texture app.
The TV News Time, 7:50.
Fall in love with the great life. Coming soon, Park Terraces at Valhalla Town Square. The next chapter in luxury condominium living in Etobicoke. Coming soon, Park Terraces at Valhalla Town Square by Edelpan. One-bedroom suite from the 300. Register now at ValhallaTownSquare.com. That's ValhallaTownSquare.com.
The Everly Brothers Experience, featuring the Smed Brothers, live at Niagara Falls View Casino. From March 20th to 22nd, the Smed Brothers will pay homage to the musicians who set unmatched standards for two-part harmony. The Everly Brothers. Visit FallsViewCasinoResort.com for tickets.
Here he comes.
The Everly Brothers Experience, featuring the Smed Brothers, live March 20th to 22nd at Niagara Falls View Casino.
City News Time, 7:51.
Time for 6:80 News. Traffic and weather together on the ones for 407 ETR. Up in Skymaster 1, Daryl Dahmer.
We've got a 4-kilometer backup on the 407.
At northbound 427, followed off the Gardner to Rathburn in the Express. Log into your web account today. You can win a year of free travel on 407 ETR. For more details and to see how you get up to 2 bonus entries, visit 407ETR.com. With the forecast, meteorologist Jill Taylor.
A very mild forest today with a southwest wind and the scattered showers. We get into a steadier rain tonight for early tomorrow morning, and then falling temperatures. Could be a brief period of freezing rain tomorrow afternoon as well. That changeover should take place, or at least at this point anyway, will take place around 1 or 2 o'clock tomorrow afternoon, and we could have a couple of centimeters of snow tomorrow afternoon into the evening as well. So big change on the way. The guaranteed high, 9 degrees, will stay near 8 overnight and 4 tomorrow morning, and then the falling temperatures, -1 for tomorrow afternoon and -14 for the low. Very cold weekend, -11 Saturday, could start Saturday with some snow and then partly cloudy, -7 Sunday. Right now the wind quite gusty out of the south-southwest. It's mostly cloudy, appears in 8 degrees there, just some scattered showers, so north and east GTA, 6 and cloudy at 6 City News, guaranteed high, 9. Coming up at 8 o'clock, what the weather roller coaster Jill just told us about is doing to the city's water main.
6 City News Time, 7:53.
The holidays were awesome. We went a little overboard this year. The kids scored the latest gadgets. My wife loves her laptop.
Honey, what's the password?
And my new flat screen? 55 inches of amazing. But when the credit card bills get here, we won't be able to make our minimum payments. Somebody help us.
Need a home equity loan? Consolidate your debt and save over $400 a month. You'll just love the freedom. Visit freedomlending.ca.
Use your home to get a loan. Freedom Lending.
License 12762.
Blue Monday is around the corner. But not when we're hit with gloomy weather. Bill payments are due. And resolution.
We now know who will be in attendance. The team posting the roster of current players, prospects, and alumni fans can meet. The go-tos are there: Russell Martin, Marcus Stroman, Kevin Pillar, Kendrys Morales, plus blue chippers like Vladdy Guerrero Jr. and Bo Bichette. But there's a whole alumni roster which has me jacked. Robbie Alomar, George Bell, Vernon Wells, Pat Henkin, plus Jose Cruz Jr., Willie Upshaw, Homer Bush. Am I right? Jeff Rahoman, 680 News.
680 News Time, 7:55.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is your Air Transat flight attendant. Attention all passengers with small children, passengers requiring special assistance, men with or without mustaches, women wearing flip-flops or not, and basically everyone. It's the Sun for Everyone sale. Until January 23rd, save up to 40% on Winter South vacation packages. Feel free to use your electronic devices to book at Transat.com or call your Marlin travel professional. Conditions apply.
Transat. Vacation is calling.
Hey everyone, Sam from Best Brand Appliance, aka BBA. I was hoping to have a little bit more time today, but of course me, I get stuck behind the person in drive-thru that ordered 426 coffees. Only me. KitchenAid's having an unbelievable promotion this month, up to 25% off, additional savings up to thousands of dollars. You gotta come check out either of our showrooms, Vaughan or Toronto. Our new showroom in Toronto is at Leslie and York Mills, beside an amazing steakhouse. And of course we have our flagship Vaughan location on Highway 7, just beside the 427. If you're thinking KitchenAid, if you're thinking premium appliances, there's only Best Brand Appliance.
680 News Time 756.
Now the 680 News Business Report for Manulife Bank. Here's Mike Ethel.
Cost of flying could be going up this year, Catherine. Delta Airlines in with its earnings update this morning, and the company is saying that it's got quite a bit of control right now on pricing power because of strong demand. Lots of Americans specifically flying last year, and Delta had a very strong year for profitability. It's raised its guidance for 2018 and says that it could be looking at raising fares by as much as 4.5% in the first quarter to offset higher fuel costs. It would be the biggest gain in almost 4 years for the benchmark gauge, which is a proxy for the airline's control over ticket prices. And that increase spurs growing optimism surrounding U.S. carriers specifically. Could have a spillover effect on Air Canada and WestJet. WestJet's in with its December passenger numbers this morning. And last month of 2017 was a record breaker for the Calgary-based company as it flew more than 2 million customers and the percentage of available seats filled north of 83.5%. Earnings in this morning from Shaw Communications, the Calgary-based company, reporting a profit of $114 million as it added more wireless subscribers through its Freedom Mobile wireless business. Shaw said it added approximately 34,000 wireless subscribers compared to just 9,500 net additions in the same quarter a year ago. The overall earnings at $114 million worked out to 22 cents per share and revenue up to $1.25 billion. Price for oil right now at a 3.5-year high at $64 per barrel. It's up 40 cents. That could elevate the energy stocks, which were up yesterday and what was otherwise a down day on Bay Street as the TSX was tripped up for a loss of 71 points. The Dow's coming off a loss of 16 points, but Dow futures right now back up by 35. And the Canadian dollar down for a second day at 79.5 cents U.S. At the Business Center, I'm Mike Apple.
I'm Brian from 1-800-GOT-JUNK. Neither rain, nor sleep, nor gloom of night will keep us from hauling away your junk.
How about a flood? Not even that. Tornado? Nope. Blizzard? Nope. Ain't no mountain high enough. Ain't no valley low enough.
What are you trying to say?
When you've got junk that needs to disappear,
all you have to do is point.
Don't worry about how or if we can get there.
We can.
And we will.
I love working with these guys. We can usually be there within 90 minutes till midnight, 7 days a week.
1-800-GOT-JUNK.
1-800-GOT-JUNK.com.
Something lurks beneath the surface, under ice and snow. A relic of a simpler time, seemingly unwanted, but with a higher purpose than you could imagine.
You talking about my station wagon?
Uncover the possibilities.
You mean clear the snow off? Forget it. I'm calling Jimmy Carr.
Donate your unwanted vehicle to Kidney Carr and help the thousands of Canadians living with kidney disease. Get a total for free and a minimum $300 tax receipt. Visit kidneycar.ca. Donate. Feel great.
Now, 680 News regional weather conditions for Walmart. At Walmart, the lowest price is everything. That's why 828-mil Palmolive dishwasher, $4.44 each. Walmart. Save money. Live better. In Guelph, cloudy, 7 degrees. In downtown Toronto, it's cloudy and 6 degrees. 680 News at CFTR is 8 o'clock.
Number one for breaking news, traffic, and weather. This is 680 News, Toronto.
Here are Paul Cook and Catherine Zete.
Good morning. This is Thursday, January the 11th. In for Paul Cook, I'm Steve Roberts.
Here's what's making news right now.
Toronto has seen a whack of water main break.
Oh, yeah, it's pretty big. I wouldn't want to be driving near it.
And with another wild temperature dip on the way, there will be more road craters created.
Deadly mudslides triggering a search for survivors in Southern California. A massive area affected with celebrities like Oprah caught off guard.
That mud goes 300 feet wide all the way down to the 101.
An alleyway fight near King and Bathurst results in one man being shot.
The Public Health Agency of Canada says you should be able to put romaine lettuce back on your grocery list following a deadly E. coli outbreak.
The Senators stunned the Maple Leafs. The Raptors have home court for the Cleveland Cavaliers tonight. Sports at 15.
Saying it's going to raise U.S. wages and give bonuses to workers after U.S. tax reform. Dow futures up 40 points. Dollars down. The price for oil at a 3.5-year high. Business at 26.
6:30 News, time 8:01.
Time for traffic and weather together on the one, brought to you by Sportsnet. Heading airborne now to Skymaster 1 and Daryl Dahmer.
Westbound on the 407, approaching King Lawn, right lane block there. We've got a pothole, we've got a number of vehicles on the shoulder. Police are on the scene. The 407 has been notified about this. And westbound, we've got a 4-kilometer backup on the 407 as you approach York Durham, where the right lane is blocked. Westbound on the 401, a series of problems are clear. Still delays out of Whitby over to west of the 412. The busy West 401 on Morningside to McCown and the Express, Morningside over to Kennedy and the Collectors. West 401 delay 44th Avenue Road, also on the Express to Collectors from the 680 Traffic Center, Jordan Kerr.
Well, Toronto Bend on the QEW is slow from Nicholas Haswell over the Skyway to approaching Fairview. Then east on the QEW is slow from Walker's Line to 3rd Line. Then east of South down to Dixie. Eastbound on the Gardner slow from Islington in the Express to east, to the Spadina Ramp and then to the Jarvis Ramp. Southbound 427 approaching Rathburn in the Express. Problems have cleared. It's back up from south of Airport Road to approaching Rathburn in the Express. Northbound 427 still very slow north of the Gardner to Rathburn in the Express. And from Bloor to Bernersdorf in the Collectors. The Honda 2018 NHL All-Star Skills Competition, January 27th at 7 on Sportsnet and CBC. With the forecast, meteorologist Jill Taylor.
With the showers at times today. Right now, most of the activity north and east GTA, and then turning a lot colder for tomorrow with mixed precipitation, a change over to a brief period of freezing rain, and then to snow around 1 or 2 o'clock tomorrow afternoon. Right now, the wind quite gusty out of the south-southwest. It's mostly cloudy, 8 at Pearson, 6 and cloudy at 680 News. The guaranteed high today, 9. 680 News, time 8:03.
Well, city crews already busy fixing an unusually high number of water main breaks around Toronto could find themselves with even more work to do fairly soon. The special weather statement is warning today's unusually mild temperatures will be followed by a strong cold front, providing the perfect conditions for even more broken pipes.
680's Carl Hansky is on Yonge, south of the 401, where drivers are feeling the effects of the weather roller coaster on our infrastructure. He joins us live. Carl.
Check out the drivers and people walking to the subway station here on Yonge, south of the fall. And it's opened up in the southbound lane.
Oh, yeah, it's pretty big. I wouldn't want to be driving near it.
There's a 10-foot-long hole in the pavement, but the cavern created under the pavement is as long as a barn.
Yeah, it's huge.
Follow your car.
Yeah.
Nobody got stuck in that.
Yeah, exactly. Good thing a car wasn't over it when it stuck.
Well, this is one of about 150 broken water mains the city's had to deal with so far this winter. That's three times as many as this time last year. Work crews have been extra busy, and with temperatures going from a warm plus 9 today to a freezing minus 14 by tomorrow night, they're expecting another wave of water main breaks to deal with. Reporting live on Yonge, south of the 401, Carl Hansky, 680 News.
Police say an overnight shooting at King and Bathurst was the result of a fight between two groups of people. It happened in an alleyway around 3 this morning. One man was shot twice. His injuries are not life-threatening. Police are looking at security footage to try to find the person responsible.
You're listening to All News Radio, 680 News at 8:05. The province's business leaders say the recent minimum wage hike was just too much, too fast, and they're now asking the government to help offset some of those increased labor costs. 680's political affairs specialist John Stahl is here with now with a statement from the Ontario Chamber of Commerce.
Well, the chamber is set to join in on the pre-budget consultation process appearing before the committee on Monday in Thunder Bay. And although the new head of the Chamber of Commerce, Rocco Rossi, wouldn't share details of the help it's seeking this morning, he did hint that the further hike to $15 an hour could be given more time.
There's still what can be done with the additional projected increase so that business has more time to adjust to these things. Obviously, there's always the tax rate itself, and we're seeing even more aggressive movement on taxes in the U.S., and that creates competitive situations.
The Chamber of Commerce speaks for up to 60,000 members of the business community here in Ontario.
At the political desk, I'm John Stoll.
Big City News Time 807. The Public Health Agency of Canada says you should be able to put romaine lettuce back on your grocery list. 680's Laura Carney says it follows a deadly E. coli outbreak. The Public Health Agency says the outbreak linked to romaine lettuce appears to be over. As of Wednesday, there were 42 cases of E. coli reported in 5 provinces, including 8 in Ontario. A total of 17 people were hospitalized and 1 person died. Based on the investigation, the Public Health Agency says exposure to romaine lettuce was identified as the source of the outbreak, but the cause of contamination has still not been determined. The Canadian Food Inspection Agency completing its food safety investigation, and all samples tested were negative for E. coli. You are still being advised to follow safe food handling tips, but the Public Health Agency says it's no longer advising consumers to avoid romaine lettuce. I'm Laura Carney.
6:80 News Time, 8:07. Mayor John Tory is going to be on hand for today's groundbreaking ceremony at the former LCBO property at Copper Street and Queens Quay. The 11.5-acre property is set to be developed into an office development and the city's largest mixed-use waterfront community. Tory is going to be joined by the province's finance minister, the president and CEO of the LCBO, and developers as well.
This is 6:80 News. Some Indigo stores reporting low stock of the new book which details the first year of the Trump White House. Fire and Fury arrived in Toronto bookstores yesterday. Amanda Ferguson of City News is speaking to customers at the Indigo in the Eaton Center.
I don't want to go near it because it's too angry. It's just Fire and Fury. And for me, it's a little bit too much, a little bit overwhelming for me.
He contradicts himself and continually pumps himself up, and it's good to see someone take him out for himself.
We all just feel concerned about what's going on in the White House. Whatever decision we make will have a great impact on the world. Trump has denied any truth to the claims detailed in the book.
The book was written by American journalist Michael Wolff, who says he has unfettered access to the West Wing for almost...
T.com/John. That's TCET.com/John. Coordinated by Center for Education Training and funded by Employment Ontario. Well, the holidays are long gone, but the bills, well, they're right here and piling up. Hey, if you need to take care of some debts and have a lower credit score, we have a solution. BoreWithYourHomeOrCar.com.
BoreWithYourHomeOrCar.
With Chris Financial, if you have a paid-off car or equity in your home, get one of those.
Help us tell a big story as the temperature falls tomorrow. We'll have the showers at times today, rather scattered. The guaranteed high, 9 degrees, near 8 overnight.
and rain tonight and for tomorrow morning. And then the falling temperatures with that gusty northwest wind tomorrow. We'll start with the rain and then a brief period of freezing rain. Looks like that changeover could happen around 1 or 2 o'clock tomorrow afternoon. And then even some snow, a couple of centimeters could accumulate. It'll be a cold night Friday, minus 14 for the low, and a cold weekend as well. We may start with some snow Saturday, the high only minus 11. Right now, not the wind out of the south-southwest. It's mostly cloudy, 9 appears, and 6 and cloudy at 6:80 News. The guaranteed high today, 9. 6:80 News time, 8:13.
Now time for the TD Market Minute.
Over to the 6:80 News Business Center and Mike Apple. How are things looking, Mike?
Not bad, Catherine. Dow futures now up 4.